too many things more cute than second graders getting ready for First Communion. Except maybe this. This is one of our parishioners, Sam's bringing in a little puppy. She's adorable too, of course, yeah. But this is an Alaskan husky. How old is she? 2.5 months. And her name? Grace. And she's very, very soft. So the wonderful thing about dogs, especially cute puppies like this, is that they just are glad to see us. Does everyone notice that? Those of you, some of you are cat lovers, we got that. But you dog lovers, you know. You're having a bad day at work or school, the dog is there saying, I love you, it's good to see you, I don't care what happened to your day. Or let's say you're having a bad hair day or you got a zit on your face, the dog says, I don't care, you're beautiful to me, and the dog just wants to love you more and more. It's so adorable. So maybe some of you first communicants want to get a closer look. So she's going to ask you one at a time. So all the first communicants, yeah, here, just sitting here, once you come up. You stand behind the table, why don't you? So everyone can see you. You stand behind the table. Yeah. Yeah, that's right. She's soft. Now, you gotta imagine that the joy that these kids feel, and certainly the joy that dogs seem to bring out in us, is probably like what the disciples felt in that gospel reading today. You just heard it. They said, we're not our hearts. Joy burn on our hearts, burning within us. And you got to think again that that joy comes about because they had Jesus present with them. Now you know, so you just heard it. And it said Jesus is with them, not from afar. Jesus is not like looking up from the heavens, or Jesus is not walking in front of them or walking behind them. Jesus is right there with them, walking alongside. You just heard it. And then it says that the disciples were confused. They didn't understand some things, and then Jesus explains things to them. And then when they sit down at table, he blesses the bread, breaks it. Then it's like, it's obvious now. Jesus is with us and has always been with us. So kids, why don't you go back? You go down. Let's let the other first communicants come out. Let's look. Yeah, why don't you stand behind the table so everyone can see you. Stand on this side of the table. Let's see. There you go. Everyone on this side of the table. There you go. Stand on this side, Chris. Everyone can see. Well, you gotta imagine that when Jesus says that I want to be close to all of you, it's in the same way. Jesus is not someone like way out there, far away. Jesus is right there with us, walking alongside us. And many times we are confused about things happening. Why did this happen to us? Or what's going on with this? And it's just like Jesus saying, yeah, I want to explain things to you. I want you to understand things going on. And how do we understand? That's because of the Eucharist. When we gather at the Eucharist, again, is that whole revelation is like, that's what he wants us to know. That we have hope. That he's always with us. And no matter how dark life seems, no matter how awful something is, Jesus says, I'm there with you. I give you hopefulness. No matter how discouraged you are, no matter how much wounds you have, he says, Jesus said, I'm not going to leave you, but I give you that sense that I'm always with you. Okay, kids, y'all get a pet? I'll send you guys back down. It's as if through the Eucharist we have that understanding that God is with us always. That God says, I'm going to give you that hopefulness. And for many of us, we say, what is God like? I mean, I don't really understand this presence. We talk about having a relationship with Jesus or God. Well, for some of you who don't understand how God is with you, I think a great metaphor is, say, with a dog. Just like this, that God is right there saying, yeah, I'm there for you, I love you no matter what. That no matter what happens in your life, I'm going to be there to help you and protect you. So like you. There we go. That God says, I want to be there in every step of your journey. That I want to help you in we become that Eucharist, so that we know that God is with us. We come to eat that paschal mystery, that hopefulness. God says, no matter what,